Human rights advocate Felicia Dujon understands the economic constraints faced by residents and appreciates it when government agencies step in to provide employment opportunities outside of the country. While there are benefits to this, she's concerned about the serious human rights violations that citizens are reporting while on the job. She says the time has come for policies to be put in place to protect the rights of these workers.
Our responsible agencies, the agencies that are responsible for the safekeeping of our citizens, to ensure that our citizens' rights are protected, that their rights are not infringed upon, regardless of what societies or what countries that they are. I believe the time has come when we have to place various policies and guidelines to those various farms in terms of the treatment of our citizens. We cannot be in a place where poor treatment, ill treatment of our citizens would make certain societies and certain organizations believe that because of our economic background, because of our economic hindrances, that their rights should be violated.
Mrs. Dujon's comments follow reports of ill-treatment by local women on a Canadian farm, including verbal and even physical abuse. In light of this, she recommends frequent visits to the farms to ensure that there is no reoccurrence.
Too often that we've heard of persons who have been in those situations, who have gone on those programs, have very ill concerns, are very dire concerns of what has been happening to them. Those experiences should tell our government that something has to be done, some form of intervention has to be done. And we have to remind our policymakers that though we may be poor, we are not hungry to the point that we'll make people kick us, we'll make people take advantage of us.
She says St. Lucians ought to be treated with dignity and respect. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.